Okay, I'm gonna get both cameras going here. Got some flat stock here. I think this is actually meant for chain link fence tension bars. Just about fit in there. Well, actually, if you force it, you could slide it in there. I want them to slide nice, though. So I want to take a little bit off the width of them. Take that stop off of there. We don't need that right now. Take that out of here. And we need a parallel to go like that. So let's go with two of these. That's too much. That's too much. About like that. That'll work. That will work. So now I want to put something up here to clamp it. Another parallel. All I want to do is take a light cut on that, just a light cut on that. It should do it. It should do it. All right. Ooh. Getting some material here. Try to use the end mill that I had in there. Since we're just taking a light cut, should be fine. Touch it right there. I'm gonna take 10, 15 out. Material is not the same thickness. Long way across. Looks. Looks like it's narrower on one end than the other. It's not straight. That's what it is. It's waving. It's a waving. So, decided that I took the 15 off. Still doesn't fit. Didn't I not just slide it in a ways? I thought so. Huh. Okay, well, so it's wavy. I'm just going to put it back in like that. Parallel down in here to hold it in place. And I'm going to come down until I touch on that end. Oh, dribble flip it. This material might end up too narrow by the time you clean up the sides. That edge now should be straight. If it didn't warp during cutting, I don't think it did. We didn't take enough off to make it warp. Alright, so now let's take, see if it can straighten out the other side. And then again, let's narrow it down on that end. Not by much, though. Okay. I'm going to do some buffing on that to get the burrs off. Let me buff the corners off of this here. See what we got. A little snug yet. I think if I grind that corner off, I'm gonna run the grinder, take it on the grinder and just grind a chamfer on that. Let's see what we get. That's it. Alright. So now we gotta figure out how long we want those nuts to be. And then we'll set the stop on the saw and just chop saw them. And then we'll come over and drill them down. probably, you know, you got 5/16 bolt in there. An inch long would be sufficient. So I'm going to go over on the saw, set a stop, and then cut 1 inch. Either that or just measure them. Cut 1 inch pieces. So I will be back. I'm just going to let the cameras run, but I'm going to cut it out on the
editing.
Put her stop back on. Okay. Yeah.
Switch collets, put the air finder in.
Get the center first.
Why?
I'm wondering. Do I want to drill them this way? If I drill them the other way, will there be enough room? Because if I drill them, turn them this way, then I don't have to take the parallels in and out. That's what I'm going to do them this way. All right, so now I will pick up the edge and the edge for the center, and the edge for the center. All right, because we want that hole kind of on center. All right, we'll pick up this side for the back jaw. Right there, zero, front jaw. Boy, somebody just went ripping by on the highway. Right there, half, turn to zero. Right there, lock my Y, pick up the edge of the part. Right there. Zero my X. Move over to the other side. Come down. And pick up that edge. Go down a little bit further. Yeah, see. There's a little bit of radius on that.
You want to get out down below that. Right there, and go X half, turn to zero, and we are in the center of that part now, hopefully.
All right, need 5/16 drill again,
or 3/8 16.
Well, no. Those aren't 3/8-16. Those are 5/16-18. So, is that a letter F, I believe?
Yep, letter F.
257. Alright. And we might as well use that spot drill again. Same spot drill. Put the drill chuck back in. And we're gonna have to crank her down. Which is fine. I'm not worried about losing position because it would only be 2 or 3 thou, if even that. I don't fit in there now. How about this? Not yet. There we go. Oh, I need a 5/16 tap.
5/16, 18.
And we need some tapping stuff. Molly D. Alright, we're ready to roll. Here we go. First one. Going to worry about chamfering or deburring them because they're so thin that I don't want to take in away any of the thread that I don't need to. Tap. Oops. Let's get some at least ones. Switch to low. Here we go. All right, one down. One down, seven to go. Yeah, we got about three. Three threads in there is all, but that's fine. That should be enough to tighten that up. Back to high. And that's with F, that's 75% thread is what it is. Back to go. Two down. Now the edges are just sawed, so they're not parallel, so they might move a little bit this way or that way. That saw usually cuts pretty straight, though.
Don't want to move my trail all over there.
Alright, well, you've seen me make three of them here. I'm going to cut away and finish them up. And then the next time we'll be assembling stuff. Camera's off. We'll be at the bench next time.